It is estimated that 450,000 of the world's population suffer from multi-resistant tuberculosis. But in 2013, less than 100,000 received treatment. This type of tuberculosis is called multi-resistant because it's resistant to the two main antibiotics commonly used to treat it. Multi-resistance is a real nightmare for patients and a headache for their medical teams, as treatment is long, 2 years. Complex, toxic. It's not even effective, as only half of patients make a full recovery. Varden is 60. The multi-resistant tuberculosis he suffers from was first diagnosed 8 years ago, and he has to take a huge amount of drugs every day.
I've been taking the drugs for almost 7 years. I know them off by heart, and I know each of their side effects and what they do to me. In the past 7 years, I've had 8 months at home with my family. I've been in hospital for the rest of the time, 6.5 years.
Bedaquiline and Delaminid are two new tuberculosis drugs and the first real hope for these patients. Currently in development, these two drugs are often not registered in the worst affected countries. Consequently, less than 1,000 patients around the world benefit from them. The reason for this underutilization is that little is known about these drugs, especially their side effects and how they interact with other treatments.
These new molecules are a huge hope for patients with TB, but they're only half the battle. In order to comply with international recommendations, they must be taken in addition to current multi-resistant tuberculosis treatments.
To speed up the process, MSF decided to launch an extensive project in partnership with two organizations playing a key role in combating tuberculosis. The US Partners in Health and the Pakistani aid organization Interactive Research and Development. The project, funded to the tune of $60 million by UnitAid, was launched in April 2015. Its aim is to facilitate access to the two molecules and to define a precise treatment based on the two drugs.
Tuberculosis is unusual in that it is treated using a combination of drugs, what we call a therapeutic regimen, an association of different drugs. But these two new molecules offer us the opportunity to identify and define new therapeutic regimens or new combinations of drugs to give us more effective, shorter, and better tolerated treatments.
So the project calls for a clinical trial. The challenge is to determine the combination of old and new drugs to arrive at a treatment that is as short, easy to take, and with as few side effects as possible. Implemented in 16 countries, the project will provide 3,200 patients access to these promising new drugs.